Both Germany and France have close to 5 million residents of Muslim descent. That's the largest populations in Western Europe. But now that France has been victimized by homegrown Muslim terrorists, many young French Muslim citizens are grappling with how they're perceived. The NewsHour's Stephen Fee is in Paris and brings us this report.
Last Friday, 26-year-old Rohan Hussein was having tea at a Persian cafe in Paris's 10th district when he and his friends heard gunfire.
But a man came into the cafe. He was injured on his arm by a bullet, and he started to say, "Come on, you have to hide right now. People is getting shot over there."
Terrorists had stormed this neighborhood, which draws a young, diverse crowd from all over the French capital.
This area, this neighborhood is really popular, and you can go to the theater, to have a lunch, to chill out with friends.
The attackers struck under the banner of the Islamic State, and investigators say most were French nationals, reopening the country's long-running debate about what it means to be both French and Muslim. It's a debate that resonates with Hussein. He was raised by a Syrian Muslim father and a French Christian mother.
It's a weird feeling because it's like both parts of me are fighting against each other, you know? It's a crazy situation to be half French, half Syrian in November 2015. It's crazy. But I think, yeah, it's also a chance to be proud of this identity.
Mansouria Mokafi is an Algerian-born professor who specializes in the Middle East and North Africa.
Many Muslims lost their lives among the victims. We have many Muslims who were there attending the concert, sitting at terraces, being part of the Parisian life.
She says last week's terror attacks were a strike against the French, but also against those who've embraced both their French and Muslim identities.
They are not targeting specific people. They just targeted everybody, because now they are waging their war against everything that is French. And among the French, they are not going to discriminate particularly between Muslims and non-Muslims.
We met Iman Batou, a 29-year-old French Muslim, at a Paris railway station as she was about to take a business trip.
I'm a very, very moderate Muslim. I don't pray, I don't do a lot of things, but I believe in God, that's it. But that doesn't stop me from living, from getting a drink on a terrace, to travel, to go out. That's me, that's not my religion.
Do you feel that this attack means people look at you differently?
I hope not, but I think so.
Je pense que oui.
4 Islamic extremist attacks in 1 year in France. The shootings at Charlie Hebdo magazine in January. A beheading at a French factory in June. A thwarted attack on a Paris-bound train in August. And last week's massacre have all changed the way Muslims are perceived here.
There has always been a reluctance to accept the French from Muslim origin as totally French. But it's fair to say that since Charlie Hebdo, this feeling has widened considerably.
This mosque in Paris's 19th district, one of the city's largest Muslim enclaves, is under construction. The Muslim community here is growing and needs more space. The mosque's president, 53-year-old Ahmed Wali, says young French Muslims, those who feel integrated and those who don't, struggle with questions of identity.
In terms of young people, you do have a category who are really asking themselves questions about their identities, their relationship with the country they live in, the country they were born in. The worst error is to be in denial, to not recognize this.
Wali believes addressing these identity issues is a key step in stopping radicalism.
Those who've already gone over the edge, it's too late. They've already gone over the edge. To get them back, it might be possible. But more importantly, how do we get the ones who are about to go over the edge to make sure they don't? On that, there's an urgent job to do, to respond to their anxiety and questions.
Mokafi believes France must address economic inequality, especially in the poorer banlieues or suburbs, to make all Muslims feel part of French life.
France has to undertake a serious self-examination in order to address its long relationship with the Arab and Muslim world.
That relationship is on Rohan Hussein's mind. He still has relatives in Syria trying to flee that country's brutal civil war. France's campaign of airstrikes against ISIS positions in Syria, stepped up in the days following the Paris attacks, has him worried, as does the talk of closing borders.
So it's insane to put blame on the refugees, you know. But it's maybe another answer to fear. People don't know what's happened, so they have someone to blame, and it's the refugees.
Still, the backlash doesn't make Hussein feel any less proud of his Syrian-French identity.
You know, I'm French. I feel French more than ever. But I'm so proud of my roots, of my Syrian roots, because it makes me someone maybe different, maybe special. So I'm very proud of my identity.